what are triggers and how to deal with them in communication. Something that makes communication often very messy without both of you even knowing what it was are triggers. So let's quickly recapture what are triggers. Sometimes you might find that you are very emotional to the point where you would rationally not expect yourself to be that emotional about something. So for example, you live together with someone and this person asks you to clean up some of your dirty clothes that are lying on the floor. And although you think it's a reasonable thing to ask, you feel angry and sad and you just want to scream no and throw the clothes into their face. Seems a bit extreme, right? But say that you then remember that in your childhood, your mother would often ask you to clean up your room and she would call you a dirty sloth. And if you wouldn't clean up your bedroom, she would not give you any dinner and you would have to go to sleep with an empty stomach and be all hungry all night. And with that in mind, then suddenly we can understand the big emotional reaction just from having been asked, can you please clean up some of your dirty clothes that are on the floor? So a trigger is a current situation that reminds you of pain from the past that's still unresolved. How to manage your triggers? Well, first of all, emotions are always valid. So do validate your emotions. They are welcome and they are allowed to be what they are. So don't ever make anyone wrong for feeling what they're feeling. The point, however, is to not act out on them in any harmful way for the other person. So don't lash out. Instead, you can communicate your feelings. So for example, you can tell your partner, instead of throwing their clothes in their face and screaming no, you can tell them, I feel angry and sad and I feel rejected. And I do think it's reasonable from you to ask me, but this is how I'm feeling right now. So notice that there is no finger pointing. There's just sharing what's happening inside of you. The other person did not hurt you. You were already hurt, and this person just reminded you of that unresolved pain that you can now take a look at and heal. Clear, peaceful communication about your triggers like this will probably make the other person feel more compassionate towards you and more supportive, so that you can feel what you're feeling. And the only thing that a trigger needs to be healed is enough awareness of it. If you do feel a need for something, like maybe the other person telling you it's just about the clothes, you don't have to feel rejected, or maybe you want a big hug, ask for it. And other than that, the only thing you need to do is just whenever the trigger comes up, take a good look at it and love yourself through the process. So don't act out on it. Keep the observer perspective. And the observer perspective is often thought of as coming from the mind, but please observe with your heart as well. As you keep loving your own heart, whenever the trigger shows up, the past loses its power over you. And the other person can get triggered, of course, as well. So when you notice the other person becoming disproportionately upset, they likely got triggered. If they act out on it, if they lash out at you in a non-acceptable way, don't accept it. You don't have to be treated bad because someone else got triggered. So draw clear boundaries here. But in any other way, if you can support them, and if you want to support them, do so by letting them know that, hey, I see you got really upset about this and I want to support you. Do you think it's because of what I did, or is there maybe more underneath it? And so you can help them start the exploration journey for themselves and become aware of this trigger. It's not your responsibility, however. So yeah, it's just so you know, it's not your responsibility to help them, you know, process all their shadows and resolve all the things in them. But if you want to support them, this is how you can. Sorry, there's a fly on me. So that's for communicating your triggers. I also made a video on communicating your desires, and also I made a video with a little exercise on communicating your feelings. I also made another video, which is an exercise on communicating more clearly in general. So there's a lot to watch, and those are actually all part of a bigger video lesson I made. You can find that one on my website. It's a whole video lesson on clear communication. So if you're really interested and you like my style of teaching, then that's awesome for you to watch. You can find it on this link, and to watch it, you don't need to fill out any details or whatever. You can just go there and watch it. So don't be afraid to click on the link to my website. And the lesson that I am referring to is actually part of a bigger course I made on relationship skills. And together with this lesson, there are a few other lessons on free preview. Like one on self-love, which is such an important prerequisite to make relationships work, to not feel afraid of rejection or abandonment, not feel afraid of being alone, to not be needy. So, and also just to be happy in life. So, if you want to check out more of what I've made, there's quite some free content there on the website. So, yay! I hope to see you there. Or in other videos, or another time in life, or whatever. And I wish you a really great day. If you can do me one favor, it's clicking the like button or the subscribe button, or both. And then I know that you have appreciated watching this, and that will help me see what kind of videos are appreciated, and so I know and feel inspired to what kind of videos to make more of. And you're also free to leave any comments in the comment section. That's it. I wish you a really great day with a lot of clear communication. And I give you a kiss.